Hi and Assalamualaikum. Let me share something with you that inshallah can lighten your heart and give you hope again, inshallah. So today I want to share with you from what I listened from the Kite and Aida Azlin. So there are many parts to the stories of Prophet Musa alaihi salam. And Prophet Musa alaihi salam story is epic, but I need to concentrate on this particular aspect of Prophet Musa alaihi salam life that I believe was just incredibly inspiring. So if you guys know Prophet Musa alaihi salam, he was born with the speech defect. So some scholars have said that he stuttered, so he was not very fluent in speech, but Allah SWT single him out and converse to him directly. So Prophet Musa alaihi salam, he was known as Kalamullah. Yeah, Prophet Musa alaihi salam was known as Kalamullah, the one who converse with Allah. Can we just pause for a moment and just think about that? Like, he converse with Allah directly. I mean, not only did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala officially choose Prophet Musa alaihi salam, the one with the speech defect, to speak to the most vicious, to the most evil man that has ever walked this earth, which is Fir'aun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated Prophet Musa alaihi salam status. Despite Prophet Musa alaihi salam having that speech defect, and he was also selected by Allah SWT to do a very specific but very difficult task, which was to speak to Fir'aun himself. If both you and I have a speech defects, wouldn't our confidence level be completely low or completely non-existent? To be chosen to speak to the most evil and vicious man in the world, I can say that I will not have a confidence to face it, but that's what we think. It's not Allah thinks of us. Allah always knows the best for us. That's why I love the story of Prophet Musa alayhi salam. It teaches me that even if I think that I'm not the right person and I'm not the one who can do this thing, but if Allah chosen you to be the one, then you and I very much ready. And it's just the same thing with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulullah didn't know how to read and write, but he was the person that was charged to spread Islam. So then if Allah chosen you, that's mean you are the right person for this. Doesn't matter what others said about you, your family said, or your friends said, or you said, just remember one thing, that Allah chosen you for a reason. Work hard and inshallah everything will be fine.